Going viral, perhaps for a negative reason today, because Richard Branson's Virgin Orbit, well, it fell in terms of share price some 20%. That's after the company's first launch out of the United Kingdom failed to reach said orbit that it has in its name. And we can talk to the reasons why and why everyone was therefore searching it on Google and seeing it trend on Twitter. It's Bloomberg's Loren Grush. She covers space for us. And clearly the share price speaks a lot of words here. It did not go as planned.
No, it did not. And, you know, unfortunately, it did look as if it was going to go as planned. The way that Virgin Orbit launches, it's not what you typically think of as a rocket launch where the rocket takes off from the ground. They do an air launch style. So how they get into space, they have a 747 modified plane called Cosmic Girl, which carries their Rocket Launcher 1 underneath its wing. That plane took off as planned from Spaceport Cornwall. It reached its intended drop zone. It reached the target altitude for dropping the rocket. And then it ignited that engine. Everything looked fine. And then something happened mid-flight. We don't exactly know what yet, but it didn't reach orbit. It did make it to space, but not to orbit.
Yeah, I mean, this was supposed to be a key moment for the UK space industry, right? Cornwall, Newquay, it's like the surf mecca for the UK. The UK was ready. The UK Space Agency, which I imagine hasn't been that busy for a while, was sort of really excited. What has the response from the company been? Because this was only their sixth attempt at launching with the Boeing 747 mechanism, right? Four successes, but this is their second failure. I'm trying to understand what went wrong.
I think we're all kind of trying to understand it as well. I think we, as the company has stated, something went wrong during the second stage booster ignition. And if you were watching the live stream last night, there was some funky data coming in. It looked as if the rocket was trending in a wrong direction. However, the live stream hosts were saying that everything was going well. The social media, the Twitter account was tweeting out that they had actually reached orbit. But then we learned, you know, that was a premature tweet, and they actually ended up deleting that tweet once they found out that that was incorrect. So it's still really unclear what happened. All we know is that all nine payloads were lost, and they're going to be doing an investigation to really figure out what happened.
Hey, Loren, irrespective of the failure, what was 2023 due to be for Virgin Orbit in the UK? Were there any kind of big milestones they were hoping to hit?
Well, they were definitely looking to increase their flight cadence for sure. That's one of the benefits that they tout with this air launch method, is that they're able to be more flexible in where they launch from. All they really need is, you know, the right runway and then they can, and the right airspace, and they could potentially launch from a number of new locations. Plus, this was the first time they had launched outside of their normal launch facility in the Mojave, California. So it was a big, you know, because of the national pride associated with it, there was a big spotlight on this launch. But so unfortunately, a lot of people did see it go awry.
Right.
So it's unclear if Virgin Orbit is going to be able to expedite its launches as it intended. However, it did only make it to orbit twice last year. So it's not a high bar to clear.